convention comeback. After postponing or going virtual, attendees are returning to Las Vegas, and the difference may be what you don't see on the convention floor. Organizers are tightening safety rules for the gatherings and requiring vaccines.
CES and the National Association of Broadcasters, just the few of the firsts to add the mandate. Fox News' Drew Andre joining us live to break down the changes we are seeing every day with different conventions.
Well, that we are, John and Jacqueline. Take CES, for example, that every year more than 150,000 people come into Las Vegas for the convention. Now, they say they're not going to have the same numbers this coming January because they won't have the same international travel. But they say adding this vaccine mandate will mean more people, not less.
To allow the largest technology show in the world to look like this, full of attendees and exhibitors, the Consumer Electronics Show, CES, decided requiring vaccines is the safest way to do it.
And what we've been seeing, obviously, recently is that the best way to prevent the spread of COVID-19 is through vaccinations.
CES, that already has 1,000 exhibitors registered for January's show, will use a third party for an electronic vaccine verification, similar to what the Raiders will do with Clear Health Pass.
When we open registration, we ask people to submit their credentials anyway. So we think at that time we'll be able to collect that data. But we felt that with testing, there's just too many gaps. And we felt that this was a safer option, was going to require people to be vaccinated.
CES moved quick on the announcement, still 5 months away from the show, but wanted to give attendees plenty of heads up. Meantime, some other conventions, like SEMA, the large auto show making its return in November, is holding off on announcing their COVID protocol.
Yeah, so we've seen a lot of change over the last several weeks, and we're anticipating there's going to be continued change over the next several weeks. So really what we want to just be consistent with is we're going to follow the local guidelines when it's right to make our decision.
While losing some international guests, SEMA believes 2021 will see pre-pandemic levels of success.
Tremendous support from our industry, and we expect we're going to be able to have our industry reconnect here in November for one of our best shows ever.
Others have made the jump to a vaccine mandate, like October's National Association of Broadcasters, in part because of Governor Steve Sisolak's directive, which allows ticketed events of more than 4,000 people that require vaccinations to ditch the masks.
The Convention and Visitors Authority says they support events deciding to have a vaccine mandate, but say they will not require it for events here at the Convention Center. Reporting live, Drew Andre, Fox 5 News, local Las Vegas.